Hello, comrade. Welcome back to Workers and Resources Soviet Republic. My name, of course, is Obda Potato. Right, so in the last episode, we were manufacturing the finest Soviet wood, and I'm delighted to inform you that that is going to continue to be manufactured whilst we progress. Nothing too untoward about that. Everything's looking pretty darn good over here. We might need to set up a few more trucks in the future. But for now, it's fine. The wood is being collected, the wood is being refined into boards, and then it's being transported to the train station. I know it's not super efficient the way that it currently is. One of the great suggestions that was had actually was, why don't we put a sawmill and a wood factory and whatnot closer to the border, so then we can just, you know, truck it to the border, or, you know, a short little train journey to the border. I'm not against that idea. I'm not against that idea at all. One of my pieces of logic for putting this layout where it actually is the fact that, you know, we've got workers over here. We got a bus network set up, so we're pretty much ready to staff the sawmill. We're pretty much ready to staff the woodcutting posts. But in the future, I'm not averse to putting a woodcutting factory nearer to the border. Anyway, that is by the by, because today we want to stem this cash outflow that is continually happening. And the way that we're going to try and resolve that is by placing down one of the ways that we can make power. I say one of the ways, I believe it's literally the only way that we can make power, at least at present for sure. So we're going to try and get ourselves a coal power plant. Polluting the environment, yep, but max power consumption per day, maximum wattage, circuit breaker, aggregate storage, import, yeah, whatever the case. It's a coal power plant. We're going to try and place one down. And hopefully... We should be able to stem the outflow. The reason that I'm trying to put it up in this vicinity is because we've already got coal up here. I know that we've got coal up here. We might as well try and make... Oh, it's so close. It works. Oh, it wants to work so much. So much? It wants to work so much? It wants to work, but the bus stop's not going to allow it to work. I mean, I don't really want to put it up in the mountains. Ideally, I was thinking maybe we could get it in a place that's close to the bus stop. Yeah, I was really hoping that we'd be able to find a place right up here where it just worked. I mean, we can try doing some leveling. I'm not averse to that. However, it's going to be... somewhat of an expensive endeavor. Also, people were saying that if we buy a an excavator and just stick it somewhere nearby, then it is free terraforming. That sounds like a legitimately great proposal. Oh, hold on a minute. Speaking of legitimately great proposals, I think we just found ourselves a legitimately great proposal. Oh boy, it's looking good. That's pretty much the perfect location for it, because ideally what we'd end up doing is, I want to go here, roads. We want to get a truck aggregate unloading, and we pretty much want to put that right about there, to be honest. And then we just hook up a lorry. We could it right up there. We can hook it up there, though. That's perfect. That's good enough for me. And then we'll stick a conveyor. That's a pipeline. We'll stick a conveyor between these two points over here. I'll also try and get a bus connection. I say a bus connection. A walking route between these two places. So that'll be great. This power plant, how much did this power plant actually cost? I wasn't paying attention to the cost. Wow, it's going to cost 248,000 rubles. All right, that's a fine amount. I think that that's actually okay. That's not too bad. There's only three workers here? How many people do we need to power the power plant? 763? I mean, that's workers to construct the power plant. Big question mark still remaining. All right, let's get... Let's get you connected up. Perfect. And then we want to try and set up a... Then we want to try and set up a route between... So that's the truck loading. We want to try and get a good few trucks. How much do you take? You take 12 tons of coal. That's fine. How much coal can you actually store? I don't know. Also, it's costing a lot of money. We got a couple of buses. We got one bus there. Let me get a dumper. We'll do the sure. Three dumpers seems like a reasonably large number of them. There to there. Start. There to there. Perfect. And here to here. Beautiful. All right. That's looking pretty darn good. That wasn't particularly difficult to do. Did end up flattening an area of land, which I'm not sure we really needed. But we'll be fine. All right. This is quite a complex build in terms of what we're actually building. Right. 20 workers. 20 workers is all that's required. It's not actually that many. I am thinking that maybe we need to set up another bus service. I'm also thinking that we might just need more people in general. Right. Let's get a direct bus service right up here. Sure. Our bus services at the moment are highly questionable. In fact, I'm thinking that maybe we could even look at replacing this bus terminal with a train terminal. In fact, that might be something that would be really, really good. Because look at all of the delays that we've got going on at the moment. Like we could have a centralized train terminal. In fact, we don't even need to get rid of these bus terminals. All we need to do is shift the buses to deliver to a train terminal. And if we were to put the train terminal in this vicinity, that would be really, really good. Let me sort of brain plan that out. Brain plan that out? That's not the word that I was looking for. But brain plan. Let's go with brain plan. I like that idea. I like that word a lot. What do we need? Train platform small? Small train platform? Can't build due to infrastructure? I mean, even a train platform large wouldn't look too out of place over here. Now, ideally, we want to slot it in so it can escape. Can escape around the back of the hospital over there. Alternatively, we can just stick it in here, which I know we can't do at the moment. But it's not going to be too difficult to remove the electricity poles. That's definitely not a problem. We don't need an aggregate loading, and we don't need oil and fuel unloading. But we will need oil and fuel unloading once we start dealing with oil, which is something that I am very, very certain that we're going to be doing. Also, where's the train? Is this train going with a full load of panels? It's going with an almost full load of panels. We need another train, actually. We need another train. Oh, we've already got another train. Who would have known it? Let's have a look. What do we got going on here? Just give me a track builder. Wow, that's kind of cool. Flat car. Is that what we've already got? Open hull flat car. Does that carry panels? There we go. All right. Go. Yeah, I did say that I wanted to perhaps replace that with some proper loading facilities. We could do an aggregate loading slash unloading thing. No, not demolish. Delete. Yeah, sell for that. All right, perfect. All right, we spent a little bit of cash, but I'm pretty sure that it's going to be fine. The proof is going to be in the pudding, whether we set the signals out properly a couple of episodes ago, but I'm sure it'll be fine. Okay, so have we got any coal set up over here? We should be almost ready for the dump trucks to deliver coal. Looks like we're getting close. Looks like we're getting very, very close indeed. Right, you're going to be able to load up with coal, which is going to be lovely. That's great. Yeah, this is far too slow. I don't know if we were to put an aggregate storage unloading or whatever it's called, a train, what the heck's it called? Look, a train aggregate loading, would that be any faster? No, that's not the one. We're looking for the storage area. This is so darn confusing. They put it in such different places. Is it here? Road cargo station? No. I'm sure there was I'm sure there was a storage yard. I'm certain that there was a storage yard. I'm certain that there was a storage yard that allowed a train to run through it. Storage and warehouses. Open storage medium. Yeah, look, open storage medium. If we were to put an open storage medium, or a large aggregate storage, not a large aggregate storage, an open store medium, would that work any better? Truthfully, I don't know. If you do know, please let me know in the comments. Please let me know in the comments. I'd be very keen to find out. But for now, we've got a relatively slow process of loading up a bunch of prefab panels. But at least we're getting a bunch of prefab panels. That's the main thing. We could maybe even look at getting another train. Sure, you know what? Let's get another train. Let's just live dangerously. This is the expensive one. Let's get the expensive one. Let's get a bunch of cargo wagons. Or flat cars or whatever they're called. Not cargo wagons. In fact, kind of the opposite of cargo wagons. I always do that. I always overbuy. Can I drag you up to there? No. There we go. Right, you're loading. Go here. And then go all the way along here. I admit to you, I think that I was planning to sort power this episode, but I have yet to do that. All I have done is spend yet more money. Hold up. I see a problem here. I see a problem. We ain't got any signals on this bit of track. There we go. That is somewhat of a problem. It means that only one train can load at the moment. That's fine, though. This thing is almost fully loaded. Whoa, he's just zipped back in. Alright, let me see if we can build some track out here. Too big. It just doesn't want to work. Yeah, there's just no way that bend is gonna... Oh, tell a lie. There we go. Alright, that's not looking too shabby, is it? Right, you're in here. Start. There you go. What the heck is that? Well, if you can get around that corner, you can get around any corner. That's some motivational train cornering for you there. That's quite incredible. That is quite incredible. Also, we might have an issue here if we don't have... Or if the train comes back too fast. Yeah. Well, at least we're going to be able to load at double the speed now, which is quite nice. This is going to be a very slow process. Very, very slow process. And I'm also convinced that this process, or that this issue over here, is going to end up leading to problems. In fact... What we can do, what I'm thinking that we do, is we cancel that signal, cancel that signal, cancel that signal. Yeah. Yeah, alright. See if that makes a difference. I'm just thinking that if we don't stop the train before it gets to here, then we could be in some issues. In fact, maybe we even get rid of these two signals as well. Yeah, so we halt the train. We halt the train returning right over here until one of the slots is cleared. I think that that'll work. If it doesn't work, well, who honestly knows what we'll do. Are we getting rid of some of these prefab panels? Barely, honestly. Barely getting rid of these prefab panels. This area got power yet? This area's got power. It does have power. Cargo train station's got power as well. Is that enough power? Who honestly knows? Speaking of power, are we making any power yet? Not yet, apparently. Now, workers can access this area. Oh, they're going to the prefab panel factory. Alright, sure, let's split that 50-50. Let's get them to go to the prefab panel factory and also to the coal power plant. 5 workers that are coming to the Seldny bus platform number 2. That's great. Right, let's have a little look. See if we can actually start generating some power. We should have a bunch of coal, right? Is this gonna work? Why is this not gonna work? Does it only work if there's power over here? No. What I'm... Okay, I've had second thoughts. What we should do... I need to get conveyors. They need to... Stupid. Yeah, what we should do is we should go to an aggregate storage. We should go to... Conveyors. Yeah, here. We should go to train aggregate, unloading train, large aggregate storage, small aggregate storage. Yeah, we should go to small aggregate storage. Just to be on the safe side, you know? In fact, maybe it'll have to be up here. Yeah, try up here. It's a little janky, but I think it should be fine. Right, we'll do that there. We need to get a engine conveyor transfer thing. Get one of those there, and then get one of... Get one of these right here. Really? There you go. Get one of those there. And then let's put some conveyors. Like so. There we go. Just like that. Will that work? No, that will not work. What about this? There we go. Come on. You know you want to. Alright, it looks terrible, but it'll work. Have we got any workers yet? We're still missing workers. It's a bit of a shame. Uh-oh. Did another train get away? A train did get away, full of prefab panels. That's what matters, right? We're still filling up over here. Will we be able to do it? I think we might just be able to squeeze past there. With a little bit of glitching. Glitching is to our advantage here. Also, we're definitely reducing the number of prefab panels in the storage area. Which is great, because one of the things that I really do not want to do is waste my production capability. I.e., I don't want to max out the storage area. I absolutely do not want to do that. That's just not what I want to do. Alright, this area looks terrible, but it is set up. It's fine. Should work now, right? Because now the coal's got somewhere to go. No. Why? Why are you not working here? Building is without a power supply? I don't think that that should actually make a difference. The source is not currently sending resource. Yeah. We got a truck aggregate loading. Yeah. So why is this not operating properly? Right, pause here a second. Let me see if we can try and get some power linked up. Where's the nearest substation? I mean, to be honest, we're gonna need to connect this whole area to power in just a second. There's a power switch over here. Right. Let's do that there. And then let's do medium voltage electric wires. There we go. And now if we could maybe, will these wires cross? I don't know if they will. Looks like they will quite comfortably. Right, build these wires, get them linked up. Yeah, here. Here, and there, perfect. All right, will that now allow things to work? We got voltage, we got wattage, barely. Doesn't really mean much, but hey-ho. Also, I'm thinking that the way of linking this power plant up to the rest of everything is quite simply just to put a big wire over this hill, then down the back, and then link it up over here. That way we don't get any extra wires in the base, and goodness, I say the base, the city. I'm thinking in terms of Factorio. Hey, look, this is good. As soon as we get coal, we should be fine, right? Hey, perfect. We're producing power. But hold on, we're not actually, the power's not actually going anywhere. All right, let me see what we got. So, I'm thinking that we just link up the high voltage wires. I do believe that this power plant, hold on, I need to go here. No, not high voltage wire, medium voltage wires. Yeah, it's got four little outputs for medium voltage. So, maybe we do that? Truth be told, maybe we don't. I think, to be honest, we just get the high voltage wires out of here. We go up over the top of the hill, down to about here. I know this is like a ridiculous thing to do. Yeah. So we do that. It's too awkward an angle. That's fine. We take that over here. Beautiful. Looking great. And then we get a high voltage switch, which might catch fire and cause us huge problems down the road. But I'm just banking on it not having any massive problems. So I need that orientation. Yeah, that's fine. Good. Plug you in. Cancel that wire. Cancel that wire. Cancel that wire. And then that will go over there. This will go in there. And that will go over there. I know that we're going to temporarily have no power, but we might just survive. Right, good. Okay, so with that, we should have complete power, right? In fact, I think that our power should be great now. I don't know how much power this power plant outputs. Clearly not enough to consistently have any decent amount of power. In fact, I think we should probably get another bus set up. This? You know, let's get two buses set up. Whilst I'm here, I might as well do it. We want to get power. Power is very, very important. And I know I'm talking about, you know, rejigging the whole worker transportation department. We're going to stop using buses and we're going to get into the 20th century and we're going to use trains. Right. There we go. How are we doing? 20 people in here. That's great. That's great. We're doing fantastic. How much coal are we storing? Enough. That's pretty darn good. We should be producing power. Great. 1,400 megawatts. Is that anywhere near enough? I have honest to goodness no idea. But we should be importing less power, right? I don't actually know if we're importing less power. What if I just turn power exports off? Yeah. 0 megawatts. I mean, our numbers are still going down, but do we have enough power? I mean, it looks like we have enough power, to be honest. Nope, it doesn't look like we got enough power. It looks like we might not have anywhere near enough power. But I feel like that is because of a fundamental misunderstanding that I have with the video game. Not sending resource, that's fine. Also, how is this looking? Oh, this isn't gonna work. Oh, wait, yes it is. No, it's not gonna work. Oh, this is not gonna work. Okay, this train is... This is gonna become a real problem. Alright. Yeah, so if this train can't get past, then we're gonna have issues here. Unless you need to fill up first. And then you can get out, and then you can get out shortly afterwards. That's the only thing that I can hope for. Alright, that works. It's not a perfect system. Far from it, in fact. But it does work. Alright, good. So both of our trains got away with a whole bunch of resources there, actually. And you should be able to go straight back into the base. Into the base. I keep saying base. What is wrong with me? Into the train station. It's the correct terminology. All right. So, let's look at economy and trade. Last month, export of resources, 8,000. Import of resources, whew. Delivery cost was 80,000. Ooh, yikes. What did I spend a lot of money on? Quarried stone? Power was not very much. Quarried stone is the big one. Quarried stone is the really big one. Which kind of scares me, to be honest. Because there's no way... There's no way to get rid of that. There's no way to get rid of that at all. Foreign manpower, that was a whole bunch of construction that we did. Again, I'm pretty sure that was a whole bunch of construction that we needed to do in order to get the power plant up and running. Right, but the coal power plant is running. Is it enough to deal with all of the power issues that we've got? I don't actually know. I think that one of our problems might be is that this substation is just, it's just not able to carry enough, it's not able to carry enough megawatts to, like, it's too big. The demand on this station is too big, especially after the switch. Right, hold on a minute. Let's see if I can maybe address this. This is just a shot in the dark, really. I've got no real idea what I'm actually doing. We need a high voltage switch. Put that, like, here. Yeah, okay, hold on. I've got a plan. It's a very, very well thought out, cunning plan. Not a power transformer, we want a high voltage switch. Right, good. Get that there. That connects up there. Good. This is looking fine. You come down this way. Alright. I know we will temporarily have no power, but that's fine. Connect you up there. Great. No. This isn't working. Will that work? Angle of the connection is too sharp. It's all right. My citizens are used to being without power. Can we... What's the sharpest the angle can go around here? Oh, it's pretty good. Is that good enough? Nope. There we go. That works perfectly. All right. So, let me come down here. Let's get rid of these wires, although we can't actually get rid of them like that. We need to go to medium voltage. We need to go to cancel wires. I know that we will cut power to the vast majority of our city. That's fine. Right, get rid of you. Get rid of you. And actually, let's get rid of you as well. There we go. And what we will do is we will replace that with a power transformer. And let's try and nestle it in right about there. That's about right. Perfect. And then, what I would like to do is I would like to do medium voltage wires. However, I want to do medium voltage wires with a little bit more, with a little bit more of a kick. So these guys can carry 2.2 megawatts, which is kind of what I'm after. Right. Yeah, we should probably place that about there so that in future we won't have any issues. There we go. Looking good. And then the substation over here will also get a similar treatment. We will effectively upgrade the capacity of the wires. There we go. Looking good. Alright, how does that end up looking? Are we Are we having a continual power outage? Alright, apparently the answer is yes. Building is without power supply. Building is without a power supply. Is that because the coal power plant has run out of coal? It's because there's no workers in the coal power plant. Alright, the entire city is without power. Alright, so basically we're being held hostage by the people who work in the coal power plant. I gotta be honest, it's not exactly ideal. If we can't have power whilst the power plant is not working, then that's a little bit of a problem. Not super thrilled about that, gotta admit. However, at least the train is gaining wood panels and prefab panels and all that nonsense. Things are looking good. Things are looking really good. Really, really good. Yeah, we don't have a power supply. That's a problem. You know what? What we should do is we should set it up so it imports power, but just at a really, really low percent. 10%, right? Sure. Let's see if that makes a shred of difference. I mean, it's looking better. Hey, look, that's a much more consistent amount of power. That's fantastic. That's really, really good. Are we getting prefab panels out of the factory now? Looks like it. We are importing power, but it's we're decreasing our power. Our money is decreasing at a much, much faster pace here. Look at, you can see the whole city light up. Bring it down to 10%. Sure. The problem is that now that I've upgraded the electricity that goes to our residential area, the demand is much, much higher. Also, you can see that we're actually managing to pass enough wattage, volts, whatever. We're managing to pass enough power through these electric substations that things are actually working suitably well, which is actually quite impressive. I'm pretty happy about that. We do need to sort of address the residential concerns of our population, not just the industrial concerns, which is, of course, the industrial concerns are more aligned with myself as an overlord. Also, are there trains stuck at the other end of this thing? No, okay, it looks fine. Trains are doing good. Unbelievably, things are actually going fine. There are literally 108 tons in the area. Also, this is good. This is fine. Happy with this. We got 20 workers. We got 20 workers just chilling out over there. That's great. I think if we can fulfill our demand locally, then I don't believe that we actually end up importing energy. Because I mean, look at the rate of decrease over here. I mean, we should have power pretty much everywhere, right? Yeah, we got power everywhere, and if we increase that, it doesn't actually increase the rate of ruble decline. So I think that is actually fine. Yeah, I think that that's good. I think that is good. Okay, so we'll just leave it on like 10% of power, and I'm very much hoping that we'll be able to turn a whole bunch of coal into a whole bunch of power. And we'll never need to buy power again from external sources. Hey, that's pretty darn good. Look at that. The import of resources, I'm pretty sure at the moment, it's just, yeah. It's stuff like food, it's stuff like meat, it's clothes, it's alcohol. Electronics. Who is buying electronics? And why on earth is this happening? Electronics are expensive. 0%? Yeah, I know it's 0%. I set it on 0%. What about over here? No! Some people have access to electronics. That is not on. That is not on. Nonsense. We need to cut back. We need to cut back on electronics. If we're importing lots of quarried stone, we need to cut back on the electronics. But that's fine. So we're importing a bunch of resources. I'm not super happy with that. I'll be honest. I would much rather prefer to import the gravel myself or the quarried stone myself. But the fact of the matter is that we cannot change that. We cannot do anything about that, unfortunately. It's one of the sad realities of the situation. We just have to make prefab panels until our eyes water. That's the only way that we're going to make money here. But I tell you what, we're now set up to make a substantial amount of money. The only issue is the fact that we're importing so much quarried stone, and that money is just being pushed down the drain. Alright, can we only get one train to load up at once? Ah, that's the problem. I mean, this really isn't ideal. I'm wondering at this point, what can we actually do, though? And does it actually matter? It doesn't actually matter if this is the case. I am thinking about redoing this whole train station, but I think that we're going to have to worry about that in the next episode. I think train travel in general is going to get revamped. I am very, very serious about putting a train station right in here. It would be pretty much perfect. We get a bus station or two. In fact, can people walk to this bus station from all the way over here? They can't actually walk from all the way over there, so we're going to need to address that area. But I'm thinking that a nice big train station right in here, whilst we grow the town around the train station, that would be really, really cool. I mean, already you can see that we've got a nice industrial area, we've got a forestry area, and we've got a residential area. You know, sooner rather than later, it'll be chilling on the lake. It's gonna be lovely. Oh man, this town is gonna be so delightful once it's all up and running. Now, at the moment, you can see that we are actually importing power. That's a bit of a bummer. Not super happy about that. But that's just because there's not enough workers at the moment. And that bus is useless. Alright. Great. We need way more buses. And yeah, this is part of our problem, is that buses are taking way too long to get to where they need to go. The whole thing is just a complete shambles. So what I'm thinking of doing is, as I say, getting a train station right in here and getting another train station up here somewhere, and then maybe delivering via bus from there. I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. Anyway, ladies and gents, that's going to do it for this episode of Soviet... No, it's not Soviet Republic Workers and Resources. Workers and Resources, Soviet Republic. Thank you very, very much for watching. My name's been Robert Potato. I'll see you next time. Bye.